Hello friends, welcome to my channel Cook and Bake with V Shetty. In this video I'll be sharing another variety of holige or obattu, which is popularly called as dry fruits holige. So in this holige I'll be using stuffing made out of dates and nuts. Let's prepare the dough first. So here I've taken 1 cup of fine semolina, which is also known as Bombay rava or Chiroti rava. So for 1 cup of semolina flour, I'm adding around 1/2 cup of water. Mix it well and keep aside for at least 2 to 3 hours so that the semolina absorbs the water completely. An important tip while making the dough for holige, especially using semolina, so it's a must to use fine semolina, which is also known as Chiroti rava or semolina flour, not the rava or semolina which is used for uppittu. So make sure to use the fine one. So after resting for 2 to 3 hours, you can see the semolina has absorbed the water completely and the gluten has started to develop. Next, add around 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour or maida, 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric and 1/8 teaspoon of salt. Mix all these ingredients well and add water little by little, a tablespoon at a time, and mix it well until you get a smooth dough. Apply a tablespoon of oil to your hand and knead the dough really well. Kneading the dough really well is an important step while making the holige, so this will give a better result. After kneading, soak the dough in around 4 tablespoons of oil and keep aside for at least 4 to 5 hours until gluten develops, that is, the dough will become stretchy. Make sure to rest the dough sufficiently until it becomes stretchy. So that's also a very important step while making the holige. So the dough should be stretchy like this. While the dough is resting, let's prepare the stuffing or hoorna. For the hoorna, here I've taken around 1/2 cup of cashew, 1/2 cup of almonds. So both cashew and almonds, I have soaked it overnight. So once the almonds are soaked overnight, peel off the skin out. I have taken around 4 medjool dates. So these are very big dates, so I am using only 4 here. If your dates are really very small and less sweet, you can increase the number. So you can use around 6 to 8. Soak the dates in warm water for 15 to 20 minutes. Transfer the soaked dates, cashew and de-skinned almonds to a blender and make a smooth paste. You can add around 4 to 6 tablespoons of water while blending if necessary. Next, heat a pan and add around 1/2 cup of grated jaggery. So this is the one I am using. So this is Indian round jaggery or cane jaggery. So for making the hoorna for holige, it's better to use this jaggery. So I have grated and measured in 1/2 cup. So to this I am adding 2 to 3 tablespoons of water and let the jaggery melt completely. Once the jaggery melts, it's better to filter the melted jaggery in order to remove any impurities. Transfer the filtered jaggery in the same pan and keep it on a low to medium heat so that the filtered jaggery starts boiling. Once it starts to boil, add in the ground paste, that is the dates and the nuts paste. Make sure to add the ground paste immediately once the jaggery starts boiling. Be careful not to overcook the jaggery syrup. Combine the ground paste really well with the jaggery syrup. An important tip while making the hurna, make sure to use sugarcane jaggery or cane jaggery or Indian round jaggery to make the hurna. Using this jaggery will give a better result and doesn't make the hurna sticky. Add around 1/4 teaspoon of salt to the mixture. Next, add around 3 to 4 teaspoons of ghee, also known as clarified butter, to the hurna mixture. Next, to the mixture, I'm adding around 1 tablespoon of roasted poppy seeds, 2 tablespoons of roasted desiccated coconut, so this is unsweetened desiccated coconut, and 1/2 teaspoon of cardamom powder. Mix it well and cook the hurna mixture until it leaves the bottom of the pan. Make sure to keep the heat on low to medium while cooking the hurna mixture. Once the mixture doesn't stick to the bottom and leaves the bottom easily, so switch off the heat and let the hurna cool completely. Once the hurna cools completely, apply some ghee to the hand and divide the stuffing into equal sized balls. So next step is rolling out or shaping the obattu. So you can see after resting the dough how stretchy and soft it has become. So this is the right consistency of the dough. During the resting period, the dough will absorb the oil which you had used to soak the dough. So any extra oil remaining, you can transfer it into a bowl and use it while rolling the dough. So here to shape the holige, I'm using a banana leaf. You can also use a baking paper or parchment paper. Pinch out a small ball sized dough and flatten it slightly. Place the prepared hurna ball at the center of the dough. Pull the sides of the dough, stuff and cover the hurna ball completely. So you need to stuff the hurna ball into the dough and cover it. And if necessary, the extra dough pieces can be pinched out. Apply few drops of oil on the banana leaf. Place the prepared stuffed dough ball on the leaf and spread it outwards by pressing it gently throughout. Pat it gently throughout so that it comes in a round shape. While pressing and spreading, make sure the hurna spreads out uniformly throughout. Other method of shaping the obbattu is by using a rolling pin and dusting some maida or plain flour. While stuffing the hurna ball into the dough, make sure to seal or cover the hurna completely and it is secure. Gently roll out the dough using the rolling pin. So in between you can dust some maida so that it doesn't stick to the rolling pin. So you need to be really very gentle while rolling out the dough and the hurna spreads out uniformly. Preheat a tawa or cast iron and grease it with few drops of oil. Place the banana leaf on which holige or flat bread was shaped. Gently peel the leaf out and cook the holige on low to medium heat. After a minute, flip over and cook it on other side. Brush few drops of oil. You need to be very patient while cooking the holige. So make sure the holige is cooked on low heat so that it doesn't burn. Cook the holige on both the side until you see light brown spots, that is caramelized spots, appear. So once you see those caramelized spots on both the sides, remove from the heat. Place it on a plate and let it cool completely before you store it in an airtight container. Before serving, heat the holige slightly for 10 to 15 seconds and enjoy it with ghee. Do try this tasty and flavorful dry fruit holige in this festive season and let me know your feedback in the comment section below. If you like the recipe, please share with your family and friends. Thank you for watching.